I'm joined now by Hornets president and vice chairman Fred Whitfield. So when your good friend Michael Jordan turns 58 years old, what do you get the man as a present that pretty much has everything?
You know, you don't even go down that road. You know, what you do is make sure you wish him a happy birthday and just make sure that you share with him, you know, how much he's meant in your life and how much you hope that he has many more happy and healthy birthdays, which is what I was able to do.
All right, sounds good. I got a birthday coming up, so just remember that for me, by the way, just so you know.
I got it.
So as always, the Hornets are doing some very impactful things with Black History Month. Can you break down some of the efforts that you guys are doing this month?
Well, I tell you, Josh, it's been phenomenal, as it is every year. I feel so honored to be able to ask to sit on panels with other executives. It's not only that and me doing things, but also involving our entire organization and having them through our players speak loudly about Black History Month. And then also us thinking about economic mobility and really putting together our social justice platform, our innovation summit, and identifying having 150 companies within a 50-mile radius that are minority-owned to enter into a Shark Tank-like contest, which has been fun to see that move along and into the second round, and hopefully we'll have a winner soon.
Let's talk about the organization a little more. How have you guys been affected by the fact that you really can't have fans in the stands and you guys basically lost the whole half of last season as you try and get things ramped back up this season?
Well, it's been tough, to be very honest with you. It's been brutal financially not to be able to have tickets, sell tickets to fans, not to have any fans in our building. Certainly hurts not to be able to activate our partnerships with our community and corporate partners is very tough. But I applaud our owners for not laying off anyone in our organization, not mandating that we furlough anybody or cut anybody's salary. We've kind of slugged through this. And James Jordan, our chief operating officer, I think has done a great job keeping us very, very connected, very synergistic in how we operate our business. We're looking to hopefully speak with Governor Cooper and his team in the next week or so and hopefully welcome some of our fans back at some capacity. But we're excited about our young team and LaMelo and being able to bring in a veteran superstar, I'll call him a superstar, in Gordon Haywood, and have our other young players developing to watch Miles and PJ and certainly Terry Rozier is playing at an all-time high level. And last but not least, Josh, I'm so proud that we've had on two occasions during the pandemic have been able to open our doors and only two to the public. One, to have our Swarm the Polls campaign. And then the second, just last weekend, partnered with Novant Health to be a mass vaccination site.
Yeah, certainly love seeing the success of those efforts you guys were able to do over at the Spectrum Center. So let's wrap this thing up with a little segment called Mike or Fred. All right, you got me? So I'm going to ask you a question, and you let me know if Mike is better at it or if you're better at it. So first
now,
of all.
Now, which Mike is that?
We're talking MJ. We're talking the one and only GOAT with this one. So When it comes to the golf course, who's better?
Not even close. Hey, he has his own golf course. That's all I need to say, right? Grove 23.
All right, well, who's got the more expensive taste then?
He does, and he's got a lot more money. So that's an easy one, too.
So if I say who's the better dresser, are we going with MJ again?
Absolutely. Not even a question.
All right, who's more talkative? This one has to be you, right?
Without a doubt. You know, I'm the country lawyer. In this family, in this Hornets family. So unfortunately, even when I'm doing these panel discussions, I can't help myself and not talking too much and not allowing a lot of these other, especially brilliant panelists to get a word in.
Love that. Appreciate your time, Fred, and I'll talk to you again
soon.
Thank
you.